Hey friends, welcome back to yet another new chapter by Clarity, that is chapter on revision MCQs based on agriculture and food management. So we have taken this chapter from Economic Survey Report 2019-20, and this survey forms a very important part. So before moving on, I would like to request you to please subscribe and share our channel, and you can follow us on Telegram too. Link has been given in the description box. Before moving on to first question, I would like to suggest you everybody that since economic survey is released just recently, so there are very high questions that you will get plenty of questions from this report. So I would like to suggest you that you should invest around 30 to 45 minutes daily in revising the economic survey 1920, because many questions will be asked from this. Here comes the first question. As per economic survey 1920 released by Finance Ministry, what percent of rural household is primarily dependent upon agriculture? So primary dependency is how much? It is around 70%. A fact-based question, you should remember this. 30% is dependent upon other activities and 70% of rural houses dependent upon agriculture only. Question number 2, the share of agriculture and allied sector in GVA, gross value addition, has declined from 18.2% to how much in 2019-20? So as our economic situation is slowing down, so contribution of agriculture in GVA is also becoming less. So it was 18.2 in 2014-15, it has reduced to something in 2019-20. It has reduced to around how much? It has reduced to 16.5% in 2019-20. So you can see that in this chart, the GVA has reduced from 18.2%, it has reduced to around 16.5% in 2019-20. So this type of trend you should know, and you should remember what is its present value. Its present value is 16.5% in GVA, contribution of agriculture. Question number 3, the GCF in agriculture, GCF means gross capital formation in agriculture and allied sector relative to GVA in 2017-18. So there are two concepts, GVA and GCF. GCF is related to your asset formation, long-term asset formation, like irrigation structure, cold chain structure, right? And GVA is related to how much value is produced. So total goods is produced, their value is how much. So what is the contribution in GCF of this GVA? So it is around 15.2%. You should remember that in 2019-20 report, it has been mentioned to about 15.2%, that whatever the value of good has been produced, around 15.2% of this is used for your capital formation in agriculture. Question number 4, target to be achieved in farm sector by 2030 from 2.02 kilowatt per hour. So I have mentioned in this, in my previous lectures also, that our target for 2030 is how much? Around 4 kilowatt per hectare. So option C is the right. Here you can see that gross capital formation, the contribution is declining from 17.7% in 2013-14. It has declined to around 15.2% in 2017-18. So this is a very dismal figure, and our figures for the capital formation should increase, because if capital is formed, then only our agriculture can be mechanized, it can develop. So gross capital formation should be more than this. Question number 5, PM Kisan is effective since which of the following? So you should remember that PM Kisan is effective from December 2018. This type of date based question is asked in the NABARD examination every year. You should remember the dates of the important schemes. So PM Kisan is effective since December 2018. MSP is declared for how many mandated crops in the economic survey? The answer is given as 22, but it is more than 22. If option is given 24 also, this can be right. So if 24 is given, that is more appropriate, because if you see the list of the MSP crops, what has been released by the government, there are total 25 crops. 24 are mandated crops and one is sugarcane, that is for fair and remunerative price. Since 22 crops have been given in the economic survey, so I am marking here 22 as right answer. But in the actual list of MSP crops, you will find that 24 crops are there for the MSP. A state-based question, that is Kalia scheme is related to which state? So Kalia scheme has been launched in the Odisha state. Similarly, Mukhyamantri Kishri Ashirwad Yojana is related to which state? It has been launched in the Jharkhand state. Both are fact-based question. You should know Kalia is Odisha, एंड आशीर्वाद योजना इज रिलेटेड टू झारखंड. लेवल ऑफ मैकेनाइजेशन इज मैक्सिमम फॉर व्हिच क्रॉप, तो लेवल ऑफ मैकेनाइजेशन इज मैक्सिमम फॉर व्हीट क्रॉप, राइट. मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मैकेनाइज्ड ऑपरेशन इज ऑपरेटेड इन द व्हीट क्रॉप, दैट टू इन द सोइंग स्टेज ओनली एंड सीड बेड प्रिपरेशन स्टेज, राइट. तो मैक्सिमम मैकेनाइजेशन, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, यू शुड नो इट इज इन व्हीट. PMKSY was launched in which date? So it has been launched in the July 2015. Okay. You can see different mechanization levels in different crops. These are different crops and these are mechanization level. Like if in paddy if we take seed bed preparation 70% mechanization, sowing 20% mechanization, weeding 30 and harvesting and threshing 60%. If you compare all these data, you will find that wheat crop is maximum mechanized. So it has been given in the economic survey report and you should see the trends. You should not remember each and every data, but you should remember the trends given in here. If you study the trends, you will see that wheat is maximum mechanized crop here. Agriculture credit disbursed is maximum for which of the following states? Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra. So maximum disbursement is in Andhra Pradesh and right. So here answer will be Andhra Pradesh because it has the maximum percentage of credit in the agriculture. We'll see this in explanation. Next question, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana insurance premium for chili. The question is twisted a little bit. Chili is a what type of crop? Chili is a type of cash crop. So cash crop and commercial crops has premium of around 5%. So wherever you will find cash crops or commercial plantation crops or horticulture crops, the premium is around how much? Premium is around 5%. So right here answer will be 5 because chili you can say is a cash crop or horticulture crops. So its premium will be around 5%. So here in this map you can see the credit disbursement scenario. You can see all over the India this dark colored portion in the map shows that they have disbursed maximum amount to the agriculture. So this dark colored area come for Andhra Pradesh, you can see, and Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So three states have disbursed maximum agricultural loan. This map shows that what are three states? Andhra Pradesh, next one is your Tamil Nadu, and rest is Kerala. And rest of the India has disbursed very less amount of credit. You can see 0.1% light pink colored. More than light here is 1 to 3.5, 3.5 to 6 and highest is this dark colored category that three states I have mentioned. So you should remember this trend. A very important question, question number 13. Provision of how much percent interest rate per annum to be paid by the insurance company to farmer for delay. Whenever there is delay in settlement of claim beyond 10 days. So if an insurance company does not settle the claim beyond 10 days, then they have to give the interest rate for the remaining amount of money and the interest rate for that is 12%. A very important and fact-based question you should remember. Next question, increased time for change of crop name of insurance up to how many working days prior to cutoff date? Earlier it was 1 month, right? Now this had been reduced to only 2 days. So around 2 days before also you can change the name of the crop for insurance. Again a question from Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, the time for intimation of loss due to localized calamity and post-harvest losses have been increased from 48 hours. You can inform the concerned authorities within now 72 hours. You can inform that there has been loss due to local calamity or post-harvest losses. Earlier it was 48 hours. Now it has been increased to 72 hours. Increased time for change of crop name insurance up to, this I said that it is around 2. They have reduced to how many working days? Two working days. Earlier it was around 1 month. Restriction on import of edible oil has been lifted. This type of question has also been asked in the NABARD previous examination. So that's why I have mentioned this type of question, that restriction on import of edible oil has been lifted since April 2018, right? April 2018, this restriction have been removed. Next is CAPS is a digital agriculture platform. What does C stand for? So CAPS, what do you mean by CAPS? CAPS is Cyber Agrophysical Space System. So C here stands for cyber. It is a type of, you can say, remote sensing type of technology which you can use for in precision agriculture also. So C here stands for cyber agrophysical space system. It is the whole full form. Next question is related to National Animal Disease Control Program, that is NADCP, for control of foot and mouth disease and brucellosis. So NADCP is a program to control what? FMD and brucellosis, with a financial outlay of around 13,000 crores for 5 years from, so here year is 2019 to 2014. So this program is for 19 to 24, for the 5 years, to eradicate what? FMD and brucellosis. Next, per capita ability of eggs as per DASD report. DASD means Department of Animal Husbandry. So per capita ability of eggs is around right now is 79%, right, for 2018. Question number 21 is related to food processing industry. During last 6 years, 2017-18, food processing industry has been growing at an annual growth rate of around how much percent as per economic survey report 2019-20? The answer is 5%. It has been growing at a rate of around 5.02%. Next question, the fish production in India has registered an annual growth rate of more than how much percent in the recent year? So it has laid a quite huge jump in the growth, and the growth rate is around 7%. So 7% is the right answer. Which of the following forms the largest resource of inland fishery? So these resources have been given in our economic survey. So reservoirs form the largest resource for the inland fishery, means maximum fishes are captured from these reservoirs only. So this question can also form your part of question from the fishery section. That's why I have mentioned this here. Next question, which of the following states contribute maximum to fish production? WB, West Bengal, Andhra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. So right here answer is Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh contributes maximum to fish production due to its large coastal line. Here comes your question number 25. Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, that is PMKSY, have been launched with a financial outlay of 6,000 crore for period. For which period it has been launched? Kisan Sampada Yojana, for 2016-20 is the right answer. It has been launched for this period only. The next question is, the total capacity available with FCI and state agencies of food grain as on 30/11/2019, and this data has been mentioned again in the economic survey report. You should know this data, as food capacity storage system has been given in the syllabus, so they can match this and ask question from here also. So right here is 750 LMT. LMT is to stands for your lakh metric tons. So total available capacity with FCI state agencies is around 750 LMT. okay, so these were, friends, around 26 questions from the food and agricultural management chapter from the economic survey, and these are all important question, and whatever questions can be formed from this chapter, I formed the questions, and this will be more than enough for your NABARD examination for this chapter. So that's all, my dear friends. Thank you. Please subscribe us and follow us on Telegram with the NABARD 2020 Clarity Group. Thank you, my dear friends.